The U.S. Army has racked up 170 kills with Coyote counter-drone interceptors in operational deployment globally. Officials highlighted Coyote's achievements at the Falcon Peak 2025, a counter-drone capabilities demonstration at Peterson Space Force Base in Colorado. The service currently has Coyotes deployed at 36 unspecified sites outside of the United States. So, we're in the CENTCOM region, AFRICOM and EUCOM, said Army Major Alyssa Tallmadge, the service's program executive officer for missiles and space, referring to the top U.S. military commands in the Middle East, Africa, and Europe. As we're over there for Coyotes, we're at 170 successful kills in all those regions. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the Coyote counter-drone interceptor is showing its value. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. As per the manufacturer, Raytheon, Coyote Kinetic Effector is a low-cost, rail-launched missile variant with a boost rocket motor and a turbine engine for high-speed counter-unmanned aircraft system missions. The complete system consists of mainly three components. First, a four-tube launcher that can be installed in both mobile and stationary configuration. Second, Raytheon's own Ku-band radio frequency system, or KRFS. This fire control radar will cue Coyote to intercept their targets. And third, a generator to provide the necessary power. Coyote weighs about 13 pounds, or 5.9 kilograms. It can be launched by firing like a traditional missile from a launch tube. So Coyote could be launched from air, sea, and land. Once it leaves the launcher, the drone deploys its 6-foot-wide main wing, rear stabilizer, and tail fins. The operator can now issue commands to control and direct it. The Ku-band radio frequency system is a 360-degree radar that senses incoming drones, rockets, artillery, and mortars. It can detect Class 1 UAS out to 10 miles, or 16 kilometers, and can even detect objects as small as a 9mm bullet. Coyote has multiple variants, Block 2 and its subtypes, and Block 3. These include both kinetic and non-kinetic types. In U.S. military terminology, kinetic typically denotes missiles or conventional weapons that directly impact their targets. On the other hand, non-kinetic systems, like electronic warfare tools or high-powered microwaves, employ alternative capabilities to disable enemy systems. The Coyote 2 is a kinetic interceptor, whereas the Coyote 3 operates as a non-kinetic interceptor and carries unspecified payloads, which is likely to include electronic warfare systems or high-power RF pulse emitters. Unlike its expendable counterpart, Raytheon claims that the non-kinetic variant can be recovered, refurbished, and reused without leaving the battlefield. The speed, range, and endurance depends on the variants. For example, Coyote 2C has a speed of 345 to 370 miles per hour, or 555 to 595 kilometers per hour, a range of 130 kilometers, or 80 miles, and an endurance of about 2 hours, depending on the variant. Coyotes can be set up within 30 minutes on a vehicle or in a fixed location. According to Raytheon, multiple Coyotes might be able to defeat drone swarms too. The company could load it with software that it developed as part of the U.S. Navy's low-cost UAV swarming technology effort, or LOCUST, which lets them operate as a group. There are multiple platforms being configured as mobile counter-UAS solutions. For example, a 4x4 MATV mine-resistant vehicle has been armed with Coyotes and 30mm XM914 automatic cannons, along with radars and other sensors. On February 9th, the military branch confirmed its commitment to acquire 600 ground-launched Coyote 2C devices for a sum of $75 million. Contract award was part of an Office of the Secretary of Defense Rapid Acquisition Authority that was identified to Congress, with all actions completed in less than 30 days from the authorization approval and receipt of funding. Viewers may note that this deal follows a request for information for the acquisition of around 7,000 Coyotes. The December solicitation was for 6,000 Block 2 Coyotes, 700 Block 3 Coyotes, 252 fixed launchers, 52 mobile launchers, 118 fixed KU band radars, and 33 mobile radars. The move came only 2 months after a Department of Defense official raised the urgency of acquiring anti-drone technology. In December, Undersecretary of Defense for Acquisition and Sustainment William LaPlante, citing the heavy use of drones in Ukraine, said that the United States needed to increase its counter-drone capabilities quickly, saying the military needs it at scale. "It's an urgent issue," LaPlante said in a defense conference that month, mid-January, calling the situation a crisis. Ongoing conflicts, such as in Ukraine and the Middle East, have shown the impact of small drones. Relatively cheap drones are becoming the weapon of choice for many military forces because of their cost-effectiveness and ease of mass production. The disclosure regarding Coyote's use in combat comes at a time when U.S. Army leaders have expressed concern regarding the proliferation of drone technology. For some time now, the U.S. Army has been trying to boost its counter-drone capabilities. Earlier this year, the U.S. Army announced plans to create 9 new counter-small UAS (CSUAS) batteries as part of a larger restructuring aimed at significantly expanding air and missile defense capabilities. Additionally, the Army is fielding or exploring a range of counter-drone technologies, including containerized systems that launch 70mm laser-guided rockets, as well as gun-equipped robot dogs or other uncrewed ground platforms. Recently, the service also demonstrated its AH-64 Apache helicopter's capability to engage uncrewed aerial threats using radar-guided AGM-114L Hellfire missiles. The performance of Coyotes in real combat scenarios is good news for the U.S. military, which may have to face mass drone attacks in a not-so-distant conflict.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.